start from zero and all the integral positive values. So we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. If I put here these values, then P naught in terms of x, not in terms of cos theta, we just derive this one that it is equal to 1. P1 of x is x, and P2 of x is half 3x squared minus 1. P3 of x is half 5x cubed minus 3x, and similarly P4 and so on. So let me now plot these things, that half that what is the behavior of these polynomials. Now P0 of x is equal to 1. 1 is a constant. I'm having a plot on this. I'm having x-axis here, means the value of x here, and on this I'm having P L of x, the polynomials. So when it is P naught, this is equal to 1 and it's a constant. So at x equal, at L equal to 0, I'm having the value of polynomial is 1. So this is somehow, I will have to plot from minus 1 to plus 1, and it is this value that the polynomial is equal to 1 here. So I will have just a straight line, 1. This value is 1. When I come to the polynomial x, now x is a straight line equation, so it will be somehow reaching here, here, and let's say this is the final point. So when it is x, I am plotting from minus 1 to plus 1, so x will be equal to something like this, and similarly extend this to minus 1. So we have the next polynomial is this yellow line. Now it's a straight line, and it says that this is direct equal to x. Now when I come to the next polynomial, the next polynomial is half 3x squared minus 1. From 3x square means x square, I know that it will be somehow like this. It will be parabolic. But now what will be the exact value? If I put x equal to half, then this value will come out to be 3 and half. It will come out to be 4 minus 1, then it is minus 1 over 4, and minus 1 over 4 and half of it. So this is minus 1 over 4 from here, because this is 1 over 2, and we got 4 minus 1 over 4 and 1 over 2. So we will have minus 1 over 8. Now it here, let me plot this one like this, that at x equal to 0, this value is 0, and I am having P2 of x is minus half. This point is minus half. So our value will go something like this, that it will be centered here and it will be touching here, because all these polynomials are normalized. So they will run from minus 1 to plus 1, from minus 1 to plus 1. If I consider only the positive side, then from 0 to 1, 0 to 1. So it will be somehow like this. and it will be touching here. Similarly, on this side, it will also be like this. So we will have this polynomial like this. Now come to the next one. This is x cube, but minus 3x as well. First focus on x cube. Now x cube, I know that it is somehow like this. This is x cube. But now this x is also playing the role with this. This is x. But this is minus, means subtracted from this. So the slope is minus 3, and it will not be like this, but it will be somehow like this. So this slope will be like this, and we will have the addition of this line with this line. And we will, when I plot this one, suppose x is equal to 0, then we are having the central point here, because polynomial is 0 as well. And now when x is equal to 1, so we are having 5 minus 3, and 5 minus 3, 2 and 2, so it is equal to 1. Polynomial is 1. So it is normalized, that's why we have this. When x is equal to half, then we are having half, so it is 5 over 8 minus 3 over 2. So this we have, means 5 over 8 minus 3 over 2. I can simplify this one, and this will be somehow like this. Let me plot it accurately, that it will start from here. Let me plot it accurately, and this will start from here, and means at 1, it will go like this, and it will touch this point 5 here. So it will be somehow like this, and then it will touch here. So it will start from here, and it will touch here. And like this. So it will be like this. And similarly, we can plot all the polynomials. So we got P0, P1, P2, and P3. This is a constant term, straight line, then the parabolic term, and then this oscillating term. If I look the straight line, then it is passing through no zero here, because this is 1. So this is not crossing this y-axis at any point. If I look at the straight line, then it is having one node here, because at this point it is passing through the zero on y-axis. If I consider this one, then it is touching the y-axis at this point, as well as this point. Now this point is the y-zero here, and this point is the y-zero here. So, and if I consider this one, then this is the zero point, this is the zero point, this is the zero point, and we are having, for example, for this one we are having no node. While for the next one, this we will have one note for the straight line, and for the parabolic we are having two notes, and for the P3 of x we are having three notes here. That it's touching here, 8, 0, touching here and here. So these are, means the more I go to the polynomials, they will be, the number of nodes will increase. So this is the one of the plot of the Legendre polynomials, and now we will plot the associated Legendre polynomials, which are the PLM of X, and then we will understand them and we will go one by one in order to set our way from mathematics to physics. Now here we discuss the associated Legendre polynomials, and we know that PLM of X is 1 minus X squared M absolute by 2. The mth derivative of the PL of X, which is PL of X, is the Legendre polynomial. So here we will have to keep in mind one thing, that the conversion between the Cartesian coordinate and the angular or the polar coordinate is x equal cos theta, where r is equal to 1. If we do calculate p0 of 0, then this is 1, and in the theta terminology or cos theta terminology, it is 1 as well. p1 of 0 is x, and x is equal to cos theta. Similarly, if I write p1 of 1, then it is 1 minus x squared square root. If I put for x equal to cos theta, 1 minus cos square theta is equal to sine theta. Similarly, this one, for x I will have to put cos theta, so it will be equal to this. Here for x I will put cos theta, and this one comes out to be sine theta, so 3 sine theta cos theta, and this one is 3 times sine square of theta. Now when we do plot them, then we are plotting r equal to PLM of cos theta. And we will have to do two things, that we will have to rotate our plot around the z axis, and instead of cos theta we will plot a function of theta only. So when it is equal to 1, then it will be a spherically symmetric distribution, and it will be completely a sphere, or in two dimensional it is a circle, p0 of 0 here. Then p1 of 0 is equal to sine theta, and sine theta, when we rotate this around the z axis, then it is like this. And the other side I can plot, so it's just like two same circles here and here as well. And if I plot p1 of 1, then it is something, p1 of 1 is here, p1 of 0 is x, and p1 of 1 is sine theta, so it is again the same thing, but it will be like this. So it's again circle like this, two circles here. And when I plot p2 of 0, then it is somehow like this. P2 of 0 is cos square theta. Cos square is this one. Cos is this one, and square terminology will actually make another additional, like a donut here, and it will be like this here. While when I plot P21, then it is something like this. The plot of P2, 1 is 3 sine theta and cos theta. So it will be something like this.